Good morning, guys. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So, do you know that there is an artificial intelligence machine in the world that has got the first ever patent registered on its name? Yes, guys, you have heard it right. So now, in the race of humans who were getting the patents, there is an artificial machine also that is competing, and that has got the first ever patent in the world for inventing another machine. Now, what is this news all about? That is, we are going to discuss in this video. Apart from this, we are also going to discuss about the new scheme that the government has launched. Also, the merchandise export target that the central government has fixed. So there is a lot of information for you guys that is there in this video. So do watch me till the end of this video. Guys, if you haven't subscribed our channel till now, then subscribe and hit the bell notification, because this is going to update you about the new uploads that we make on our channel. And this is the Telegram group which you can join to get the free PDFs of our sessions. So the PDF of this session will be uploaded, will be provided to you all through this Telegram group, and the link of this group is in description below. So guys, this is the first question. Which ministry is implementing the PM Daksh Yojana? Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Education, Social Justice and Empowerment, Minority Affairs and Tribal Affairs. So the right answer is Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Now this scheme is related to skill training, but of a targeted group. So skill training is not available to all the youth of our country. It is basically available for a targeted section of our society. So which section is the target section? What is this scheme all about? Now let's discuss that. The very first thing that you need to know is that the scheme has not been launched recently. Basically, it has not been launched right now. This scheme is in news because of the launch of the portal and application of this scheme. PM Daksh portal and PM Daksh mobile application has been launched, and because these two things have been launched, this scheme is in the news. Also remember that this is not a very old scheme. This scheme has been in implementation since 2020 to 2021. So this is a very latest scheme, thus it becomes an important topic from your ESI as well as general awareness point of view. So do listen to me very carefully. The very first thing is that the scheme is launched by Social Justice and Empowerment Ministry, and the application and portal have been developed by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment in collaboration with National E-Governance Division. So these two have collaboratively developed the portal and application. Now the PM Daksh scheme has a full form, and the full form is Pradhan Mantri Dakshata Aur Kushalta Sampann Hitagrahi Yojana. And under the scheme, basically eligible target group. So I told you in the beginning itself that the skill training is being provided under the scheme, but not to the whole of India. It is restricted to a targeted group. So what is that targeted group? Which kind of individuals will be eligible under this targeted group? So the individuals who belong to these categories: if they are marginalized persons of SC/OBC, economically backward classes, denotified tribes, sanitation workers, waste pickers, manual scavengers, transgenders and other similar categories. So if they belong to any of these categories, then they become eligible for skill training under this scheme. And this scheme is a very important scheme because this is focusing on the marginalized section of our society for their upliftment and empowerment. Now through this application and portal, basically all the people will get all the information related to the training centers, because the training is provided through the either the ministry's own centers or through the collaborated center, the government training centers as well as the other bodies with which the ministry has collaborated. So now the people who want to get training under this scheme will get all the information related to the scheme and the training centers only on this platform as well as on application. and they can register themselves on these two portals as well. Now remember that in the first year, basically in this year, not sorry, in 2021 to 2022, so in during this year, the target is to train 50,000 people. So this is the target under this scheme. Do remember that. So that was all about this PM Daksh scheme. Now let's discuss the second question, which is a very important question. What is the merchandise export target of India by 2027 to 2028? So out of these many amounts, 1 trillion is the right answer. As you would know that India is striving to become a US dollar 5 trillion economy by 2024 to 2025. So this is another target. 1 trillion merchandise export. We are not talking about the complete exports because they would include services export as well. We are just talking about the merchandise export. And in terms of merchandise export, India aims to become a US dollar 1 trillion market in the world. So now let us discuss it in detail. The first thing that you need to know is that the target for current year merchandise export is US dollar 400 billion, which is quite an ambitious target. But according to Confederation of Indian Industry, this target is quite achievable. Now you should know this thing that in the first 4 months of this year, we have already exported US dollar 130 billion worth of merchandise in the first 4 months of this year only, this financial year I'm talking about. And in light of this achievement, this 400 US dollar billion dollar achievement is not a very far-fetched target. The next thing is that over the last 9 years, India's merchandise exports remained within this range, US dollar 260 to 330 US billion dollars. So the exports hovered between this range only, and the highest one was 330 US billion dollar in 2018 to 19. This was when everything was normal in the economy, and this target is when the entire economy is disrupted, is struggling due to the pandemic. So let's see what happens, but the target is this. And in your upcoming examination of NABARD grade A and B, this is very important, okay? The next thing is 1 trillion target we have already set. For the next 2 years, the target is 500 US billion dollar. And in this picture, whatever I have taught you right now is written in this picture as well. So you can just have a look at this picture on your own. Moving on to the next question, which state has launched e-Nagar mobile application and portal to provide essential services online to the citizens? So this application has been launched by Gujarat. Now, a total of 52 kinds of services will be provided on this portal, ranging from submitting your property tax till paying your electricity bill, fire services, and whatever the essential services a citizen would need from the government, all those services will be provided to you on this mobile application, provided that you are a citizen of Gujarat. So that is the condition that you need to fulfill to get the benefits. Can you guys tell me what is the name of the central government's application to provide government schemes to the citizens? Please tell me in the comment section below the name of the government portal or the government application that provides the government services online. Moving on to the next question, which has become the first country in the world to award a patent to an invention made by an artificial intelligence machine. So this question kind of intrigued me a lot, because right now, till now we have heard that only humans got patents, human got copyrights, human got trademarks, because all these facilities are provided for the intellectual property that belongs to human. This is the first time that a machine is getting such kind of a protection for developing another machine, for conceptualizing another machine. So that's why it is very interesting question, but a kind of important question as well, because this can be asked in your phase one current affairs. So let's discuss that which country has given this patent to the artificial machine. It is South Africa that has given this patent. What is the name of this artificial machine? The name is Dabus. And it developed the food and beverage container, and because of that concept, it has got the artificial intelligence. It has got the patent from South Africa. Which day is designated as Javelin Throw Day in India? So it is August 7. Quite an easy question for you all, because Javelin Throw Day, it is in the light of Neeraj Chopra's gold in javelin throw. Now guys, do remember that it is the first ever gold in athletics that India has won, and Neeraj Chopra has become the second Indian to win an individual gold after Abhinav Bindra. He was the first one. So these are some of the minor facts related to Neeraj Chopra which you need to know, because anything right now related to Neeraj Chopra can become a probable question in your phase one examination of upcoming NABARD grade A and B exams. So do pay attention to him. He is a very important person right now. And on that note, let's end this session here. And I hope that you have enjoyed the session. Do not forget to come at 10 a.m. because I'm going to take a live session of July Spotlight. Thank you so much.